So this is a short commercial for mushroom use. We've both found that microdosing mushrooms actually helps reduce alcohol cravings.
Yep.
Gave me clarity. I felt like I'd sobered up finally. Yeah. If that makes any sense.
Yeah, definitely clarity for sure. Definitely the alcohol for sure.
Yeah,
you knew I was just drinking.
Yeah.
Daily. What's it called? All of a sudden, I stopped. Took the mushrooms the next day, and I didn't even think about that drink again. I couldn't believe it. I just couldn't believe it. It was testimony from the truth.
Agreed.
And you guys witnessed it. You've seen it.
Yeah.
And now I haven't had a drink since the day I switched to micro mushrooms, microdosing mushrooms. So my clarity, my focus, my life has definitely changed. And a little bit of weed at the same time.
We recommend it. Are we doing shrooms at the Mandem party tomorrow?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I want to make sure everybody's on the same page.
Oh, right? Right? I love it. I love it.
Straight up. Everybody's thinking clearly. I mean, making good decisions.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you heard about Adam?
Yeah.
Do you know who ADAM22 is? Mm. Panther, you know who ADAM22 is?
Yeah.
No.
Did you hear what happened with them?
Yeah.
No.
You didn't hear what happened? Okay, so Adam and his wife currently, I don't know, so he does like hip-hop interviews and stuff.
Yeah.
But he also has a show with his wife where they interview people and then they sleep with them. So it's it's half interview series, half porn series.
Come on.
And for the last couple years, I know, it's kind of epic still, like, to think that he could even get away with it. And he's actually pretty popular for it, too. For the last couple years, it's just been them doing threesomes with two other girls, right?
What?
They got married, and she decided it was time for her to start doing her own scenes with men.
Whoa. Oh, no, 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 no.
So she chose, this popular guy with 15 inches to do her first scene.
Wow.
So the internet's been killing Adam these past couple days. Because they're calling him a cuckold.
Marriage.
How are you?
Yeah.
How are you doing this?
You can't go back.
Well, that's it. And the worst part is she was saying, she admitted that it took her 4 days to heal. I don't know if you saw her interview.
Yeah, I saw that.
I know, right?
And she said after 4 days she was okay. Like,
yeah.
Of course I did.
Come on, that's not something you tell your husband.
Yeah.
That's not something you tell your husband.
You shouldn't have told him. But he was going to find out anyway.
Yeah.
If he's taking you 4 days to heal, he's going to know.
I wish. Almost.
Remember I saw you on the block downtown, right?
Yeah.
Come on, dog. Come on, dude, dog. Come on, dog.
Pizza, everything good?
Yeah, man.
Mine is everywhere. I'm thinking if I didn't heal you, I did, right? Yeah, man.
Hey, do you know Adam? ADAM22?
ADAM22?
Yeah.
He's ADAM22, podcast guy.
Yes. And his wife recently slept with that black guy.
Did he? Did she?
Yes, she did. She did a porno. She did her own porn.
But they're into that. You know what I'm saying?
They're usually doing threesomes with girls. She's never slept with another man before. And so now he's getting killed. And he's getting killed, too, because the black community doesn't rate it the same way. Right? So he's getting killed by, like, his hip-hop side.
Why is he getting killed? If they're porn, she's a porn star. He's a porn star. They're getting paid. They're making money. What's the problem?
They're calling him a cuckold.
Who?
His fans, his hip hop fans.
Which hip hop fans? The black guy or white guy?
He's got porn, exactly, mostly black people. So remember, his audience was predominantly black. All of the people he works with are predominantly black, so they're just not understanding it.
That's too deep, you know what I'm saying? You gotta think of like this. Nisi, this is how it goes. If you and your wife, if a husband and a wife, they're into porn business or into sex business, what's the problem? If she's with this guy or that guy, or he's with this girl or that girl, they're both with a guy. Even if he's with another guy, she's with another girl. Who cares? You know what I'm saying? It's different if we were like, oh, you know, you heard what happened with Elon Musk or one of these guys. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but that's their business.
But that guy's a porn star. His wife's a porn star. They're into their porno business. He could be anywhere. He could be sleeping with five guys. He could be sleeping with five girls. That's his business. I'm not into the porn business. That's his business. You know what I'm saying? But I guess it's something to talk about. So you know what I mean? Shout out Hot TV. You already know how we do this shit, yo. Cut and run. We're here, man. Run the cut, yo.
Would you ever date a sex worker?
A sex worker?
Yeah. So stripper, prostitute, porn star.
Well, yeah, I guess. We've been dating them. What's wrong with it? It's a job.
Exactly. Exactly.
I love that. Okay.
I like it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Of course.
Yeah? The guys are, and of course.
I'd rather, not like that, but you're saying,
those
the girls, they know the game. Yeah. Like, not the game, like, not the street, but they know, like, life, they know business, you know, they know stuff. Believe it or not, 95% of those strippers and sex workers or prostitutes or whatever you want to call them, I'm not talking about the street little junkie, junked up one, but 95% of them are nice and clean and they look good. You see the same girls, like not the just the square girls, but the square girl be, oh, that's a stripper, that's probably. Those girls, some of them, those they smell inside. Messy. But you you see the strippers and dancers and shit, that they smell like nice cream and lotion and perfume. They're always ready to go. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, no, believe me, I'll tell you. Now that I think about what we're talking, kind of freestyle now, so I'm realizing I've never smelled a bad stripper, or a bad sex worker, or escort, whatever you want to call them. All my friends that do that type of work, they all smell good.
They're all good.
You tell me, you know what I mean? Like,
Panther.
You want to start calling a couple
you blew it up still. You guys, I love this. I love this change.
Excuse me?
Would you, could you date a sex worker, a prostitute, a stripper, a porn star?
What?
Could I date anyone in the sex industry?
Yeah, would you?
No, I wouldn't.
Can you explain why? Because this guy had a deep reason for why he would.
Just because, just the thought of, it's not appealing. You know, some guys love that and will pay money to watch that or have it done, but other guys are like, you know, what's mine is mine. I don't want to share that with somebody.
Come on. Have you ever paid a sex worker?
Never. Never, ever, 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 ever.
Really?
Never would I ever.
No, you're
never.
Yeah, I know. You?
You're mad. Me. Yo, you haven't paid this. Me. You haven't paid this. You know where this come from? What?
Come on.
Yo, never.
Have you guys ever paid a sex worker?
Oh, man.
For sexual activities?
Yeah. Eh? That? No. 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 And I couldn't... I feel like I'm in court right now.
No, you're not in court. You're not in court. This is shop talk. This is what the guys talk about.
Yeah, no, no.
No?
No.
Some people like to say either you're paying for pussy or you're paying for the experience.
There you go.
Depends on how you want to look at it, right?
Well, they do say that there's no difference from going to the club and trying to pick up a girl.
Yeah, because you're spending money on buying bottles.
You got to basically buy her, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Or hope. But at least with the sex worker, I guess, you know, you're guaranteed. You know exactly where this is going, right? Yeah, it's a service.
There was a time before what we consider modern day dating, where dating was almost like a form of prostitution.
A witch?
Where dating, remember there was a time when people got married, like right out of high school. There were different expectations.
Yeah.
Women that would date were considered like, it was like a form of prostitution at the time.
Yeah.
Because then you'd be with a man for experiences. So because he can't pay for that dinner, because he can't go to that movie. Like, it was actually considered like a transactional.
You see?
So.
Okay, what's really changed?
I think everything in this world is transactional though.
Yeah.
Almost everything.
Good point.
Because, like they say, like eventually you'll be paying for it, whether it's wife, girlfriend,
Well, yeah, exactly. Ask Michael Jordan about that.
Why? What about him?
Millions did he have to pay when he had a divorce with his wife?
Yeah, exactly.
Right? Half of his money. Is that prostitution? It was probably cheaper if he had a prostitute. He wouldn't have to pay all this money, right? So I don't know. Look at it from that angle, too.
If the pay was great, if the pay was fantastic, and none of us would ever find out about it, would you ever do like a porno? Or? No? I don't have sex toys. I don't believe in sex toys. Sex toys are actually kind of dangerous for women's vaginas. You can make yourself numb to like natural stuff.
Oh, okay. No. Sorry.
If the pay was great,
yes.
Would you consider ever doing like a porno?
Yes, if the pay was great, have to be
Big money. Big money.
Like, let's say 10K for one scene. 10K for 40 minutes.
No.
10K is not enough?
No.
You have for 40 minutes?
No, man. You have to have big money.
For one scene. Would you ever consider, if the money was really good, nobody would find out, nobody that you knew would find out, would you do like a porn scene?
Do a porn scene?
No. 10K for 40 minutes isn't worth it?
10K?
10K for 40 minutes scene?
I can't.
Yeah, probably.
I can't.
I know math.
I don't like my thing being exposed like that.
Huh.
Yeah, I don't know.
No?
Yeah, but nobody you know will ever find out.
That's true.
Well, no, it's funny, because it seems like easy money for men, but it's so strange to see sex workers like online and stuff like that. Like even the guy that she slept with, his Twitter profile is like his penis out and stuff like that. Like it feels a bit, I don't know. It feels as bad as it does when you see women do it, really.
Women aren't so, from our side, the women ones aren't that bad. We don't mind the women. We're not grossed out by any of it.
Yeah.
But you're right. On the guy's side now.
It's, yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. It just doesn't seem right.
It's funny. They make good money, right. Though, is the thing.
Yeah. Well, that's like the male strip clubs and all that stuff, right?
Yeah.
Or by Victoria Park. Sorry.
Really?
Pharmacy in Danforth.
A male strip club?
Caesars. Yeah.
Women
Caesars.
Actually go really women, wild in there.
Women were upstairs, and I think the men were on the next floor.
Yeah, cool.
But yeah, I remember walking in there and seeing males. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
But we have to walk through the bottom floor to get to the top. And I seen the male strippers in there. Like I said, it doesn't seem... It's not the same, man.
Yeah.
It's not the same.
No, it's different. It is different.
So some women love it.
Some women really love it. Some women... And the costumes on the men, too... I don't know. It's a bit effeminate with like their bums and the chaps. Some women love that.
How is that a turn on?
I don't know. I prefer my men a bit more masculine. Shani, if the pay is right, we don't find out about it. We're talking 10K. He's saying he won't do it for 10K. 10K for 40 minutes. 10K for a 40-minute scene. Would you consider doing a porno? Silver Fox. Silver Fox strikes.
I can see Sean. Yeah, I'd
definitely see Sean.
I'd do it.
Right?
Oh, yeah. I'd do it. But I'm doing it. It's got to be just the one-on-one and the camera.
Yeah.
I ain't having nobody standing around.
What? These guys used to do that back in the day. That's nothing new.
These guys used to make pornos back in the day.
Oh, really?
Little home videos. Just you and the girl, set up the camera.
Yeah. I'll cut that part out. I will cut that part out. But yeah.
Okay. Remember Como, bro?
What was it like watching yourself?
Yo, bro, this guy Como, Greg Como. I'm calling him out on this one, okay? On camera. This guy made a video, made us watch it, bro.
Oh, God.
She had an idea.
But what was it like watching your friend in action?
It's wrong.
Yeah.
It's wrong, man.
Right?
It's wrong.
Have you ever filmed yourself?
Yeah.
Listen to my yo.
Como wasn't embarrassed to do that.
Come on here, boy.
I would feel like nervous about my angles and stuff. Like my angles would have to be like better. This is what's being spoken about online. I just wanted to see what you guys thought about it. Okay. Do you think stuff like prostitution should be legal?
Isn't it legal?
No. Prostitution's, it's still illegal to buy sex. In Canada?
I thought it was legal.
Prostitution, well, let's Google it.
I thought it was legal.
They just can't hang out on the streets anymore. They just can't be on the street.
Is that a fact?
I'm pretty sure. They just can't be on the street. But prostitution is legal. Prostitution's going on right now as we speak.
Yeah, I know.
There's websites.
I know. Yeah, I know. There are often misconceptions about what is and is not legal when dealing with sex trade. Below you'll find information on the legit. The selling of sex in Canada is legal, but the purchasing of sex is illegal. So it's legal for me to sell it. It's illegal for you to buy it.
So technically illegal.
No shit.
Explain that.
That's weird.
Explain that.
It doesn't work.
It's illegal for, it's legal for you to sell me, sell
yeah.
it to me.
Yeah. So if we get caught, I'm not getting arrested, but you are.
Right. How the hell is that? How's that fair?
It's not. And it makes it riskier. It actually makes it harder for the same sex workers they're trying to protect.
That's right. Yes, exactly.
Because then your customers are shaky.
Why wouldn't they do the same thing here? Like your shit?
It's kind of risky. Doing the right way.
Right? Hey, Panther?
What's up, darling?
The question was, should sex work be legalized in Canada? And we found out... We found out it's legal to sell sex work, but it's illegal to buy sex work.
It's not good.
Right?
That's a double standard.
So, that doesn't make any sense.
How you feel some type of way? Eh? You come with this sex topic and all these
It's questions. Because this is what I've been kind of trolling Adam on the internet for a few days. This is what a lot of people on the internet are talking about.
Who, Adam22?
Yes, yeah. You heard, right?
That's some weird shit.
Come on.
Some real shit, yeah.
Did you hear his wife say she was sore for 4 days afterwards?
Yo, did you know that he called him to thank him? He called the porn star to thank him for roasting his wife.
I know. I watched the interview. Yeah, it was uncomfortable.
Yeah. He called the guy and he thanked him personally. Like, thank you for piping my wife down. Yeah.
Adam's so falling apart, you guys. He's falling apart. He's not doing well.
Like, how
are you going? Good.
Yo, you did a great job, bro. I like you. I like what you did, hey?
Yeah.
What the?
No.
What are you saying? How do you?
He's not okay. He's grinning and bearing it. He's grinning and bearing it.
I think he's a cuck.
That's what everybody's calling him. That's what everybody's calling him.
What's like a slushy stuff?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Right. Peter, you want anything for Starbucks?
No, I'm good. I'm good. Appreciate you, bro. Thanks.
How about you? You want anything?
No, I'm good. Thank you for offering, though. Come on. Okay. So, the main criticism, of course, is, oh, they've got a daughter. Well, they just got married, too. So why are you doing this and you just got married? But they have a child. What sort of negative effects do you think kids experience from stuff like sex work, OnlyFans?
Oh, that's a good question. Bullying? That's a good question. Like, they're talking about, they ask them questions. They're like, you have a kid.
Yeah.
So don't you think that's going to affect your kid in the future when they see this shit about his parents and his mom and blah, blah, blah?
Yeah.
And that's something to definitely think about, right?
Because that's
going to happen, especially in today's world where everything's broadcast.
There have been kids that have committed suicide because their mom had an OnlyFans and they're being teased at school.
I didn't hear about that, but I believe
that's
it.
Happening. Like, they're calling it almost like a pandemic. Like, it's happened often.
And the kids get doxxed at school. Like, yo, we seen your mom.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's some wild shit.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Wow.
Because porn became, I feel like with OnlyFans especially, I don't know if you guys remember, during the pandemic, it blew up.
Sure.
There was a time when I felt like nervous. I was like, is this going to be like one of the main industries for people? Like, it was messed up.
For the kebab.
Yeah, true.
What effect does it have on kids, Petey?
Eh?
The effect. The sex what? Industry. Oh, the Your sex, parents oh, working oh, in the industry.
For sure. For sure it's going to affect you. Absolutely. You're curious early.
Huh.
You know what I mean? Like, yeah, of course. So many different ways. I can't even begin to tell you. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. You know what I mean? But definitely. Kids shouldn't be exposed to that so early.
And because this is only starting to happen now. Like, you can't really have like a there were many people in the past that seen their moms in a porno, right?
Yeah.
That hasn't really happened in history. So we're just going to start learning about the effects that has on kids nowadays.
Yeah.
Which is going to, that's horrifying. I don't know. Like, I mean, I don't think that should be shared. I don't think you should see your parents in that
No, you
fashion.
Definitely shouldn't.
No. That's got to be scarring. And I think it could really change the way you look at sexual behavior in general.
Exactly.
If you see that's how your mom's rocking.
Yeah.
I think what's funny though is kids tend to sometimes be the exact polar opposite of what their parents are. So these people might end up with super conservative
they'll
kids.
They'll be saints.
You know what I mean? Yeah, like ultra conservative flipping kids.
Yeah, no doubt.
Yeah?
Thread or whatever? Thread?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Zuckerberg started a new app that completely copied
and
Twitter.
Twitter is upset now.
Yeah, they're suing.
Okay, so what did I say? What did we say last week?
You need a reason.
But this is exactly.
Yeah.
And. So this, it's all fake.
Oh, I saw somebody say that.
It's all fake. So now they have a story now.
Mm-hmm.
Now there's a beef.
Mm-hmm.
Twitter's trying to friggin', or Zuckerberg's trying to take out Elon Musk.
Mm-hmm.
Now we're going to get to the reason why these guys are going to be, get out of here with
now,
that. Bunch
distraction?
Of rich guys. Distraction.
That's what
100%
somebody said
distraction.
Today, yeah.
100%.
I'll send you the video. Yeah, he wants to go indoor.
Yeah, I know. That's blowing up.
I give a fuck about two rich guys.
Twitter.
Yeah, I'll send you.
threads.
Yo, you made one that's just like, get the fuck out of here. You guys are making billions of dollars.
Yeah, literally. And fucking Zuckerberg owns everything. He owns WhatsApp, Instagram,
right.
Facebook.
Right, yeah. Right.
So it's like,
obviously he's going to do stuff like that. Like,
copy.
Right.
Yeah, like, he copied TikTok. He copies everything. And if he can't copy, he'll just buy it.
BMW. Like, there's always going to be the, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's going to be the two. So nobody's surprised. I mean, I'm not really surprised. That's not even news.
I think Elon is really training, though. He's got this MMA trainer. Like,
yeah,
it's getting serious.
Nobody's going to get hurt. There's not going to be any blood. Someone's probably going to get disqualified and it's going to end like that.
Nah, okay. That's an interesting prediction.
What you got?
They found cocaine in the White House?
This isn't the first time.
Yeah, Hunter had a sleepover.
My gosh, you guys. Then I saw this video of Hunter Biden on television doing a bump on TV.
He talks about smoking mad crack and bagging hookers all the time. And he's, yeah,
oh
yeah,
my
he's a wild
gosh.
Boy. He's a wild boy.
So don't be surprised.
No, all those politicians' sons and daughters are all on that weirdo shit.
Yeah.
Yep. In the Oval Office.
Cokehead.
What do you do when you get to the White House?
In there.
You do shit that you wouldn't. You're only gonna be here for 4 years. Right? Might only be here for 4 years. So you might as well
go all the way out.
Exactly.
Do some shit that's never been done.
Some epic shit.
Right.
No, I'm sure. Yeah. Yeah. Right.
What Abe was going on with, Doc?
Oh my God.
Oh gosh. Oh gosh.
Did you think they got freaky back then?
What? For sure. This isn't a new thing.
He's getting black girls too.
Black girls. Controversial. Controversial.
You don't think those guys were doing that?
Funny, I just never pictured. But why wouldn't they be?
Where do you think Clinton got it from? Where do you think he came up with the idea of, oh.
Yeah, all politicians
maybe
too.
I should do this. Yeah.
Yeah.
Perfect. Perfect freaking example.
That'd be wild if they were having like orgies and stuff like that. Like, it'd blow our damn minds.
I don't doubt it.
And I see they have a documentary out now. They're just coming out with it now about the penthouse and what used to go on. No, sorry, the Playboy Mansion.
Oh yeah.
What used to go on at Playboy Mansion.
Yeah.
Like, again, this is no. Bill Clinton. I'm sorry. Bill Cosby went to jail.
I know. I know.
Stuff went on in Playboy.
Yeah,
Mansion.
I know. This is the 70s. This is Quaaludes. This is roofies,
right.
Alcohol,
right.
Orgies,
right.
Like the height of like all of that.
But my thing is, why are the women only speaking out now?
Oh, I don't know.
See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because what's his name's already dead. Hugh Hefner's dead.
Yeah, yeah.
Long time.
Yeah.
So he can't, there's no going to be any kind of repercussions for him. So why are you guys coming out now with all this stuff? And I'm sure there's a lot worse shit than what Bill Cosby did.
For the story,
hey guys.
If you cheat, you're going to cheat again because you've now changed the rules.
Okay.
Say you cheat and you're
I love that!
No,
that's,
honestly.
That's the gem. That's the gem. That's what they say. Once a cheater, always a cheater. The rules have been changed.
No. This is what I'm saying. Within a relationship, if I cheat with my girlfriend and I get caught.
Yeah.
No, if I get away with it, I'm going to do it again.
Yeah.
If I get caught and she says, I'm out of here.
Yeah.
I'm not going to sleep with you for 4 weeks.
Yeah.
And so she doesn't sleep with me for 2 weeks or 3, or say even that she keeps the 4 weeks. I go, okay.
It'll be 3 weeks.
I say, okay, I now know we've changed the relationship. We've renegotiated the rules. The new rule is I'm allowed to sleep around. You'll get mad at me and you won't sleep with me for 2 weeks.
Wow.
And
so the best
that
thing to do then, dangerous precedent set. We didn't realize we were setting that precedent.
Brain.
We didn't realize that's what we were doing.
You've learned to have it.
No.
Why wouldn't you do it again? Right? Like, yes, in the next relationship, you might not say, oh, it destroyed the relationship.
Yeah.
But within that relationship, come on. Like, be realistic. Honestly.
Right?
Am I not right?
I think it's so explosive. What you're saying is so explosive because you've blown the cover off of why it continues to happen.
Of course.
Women have been baffled. You have to understand, we don't understand that's what's happening. You are blowing my mind right now.
But
never
it's
even
so
considered
simple,
that.
Isn't it?
It's what it is.
It's
what it
is. Everything you do in life is a relationship, right? And relationships have rules.
Yeah.
And you negotiate the rules, right? So if it's intimacy, you've negotiated an intimate relationship with a person. In other words, you say, hey, you want to fuck? They said, yeah, let's fuck. That's the negotiation, right? So without saying, hey, I'm going to cheat and what's going to happen, you cheat, you get caught, and you see what happens, you go, hmm, okay. And then you're looking at that woman and say, no, she's not worth the headache. You go, that one, oh yeah, that's worth the headache. And okay. Even if, I'm not saying you consciously do that.
Yeah. So what's the way to stay? We're on the same vibe, right? We're all on the same page. I've accidentally negotiated out of my favor. Out of my favor.
Yeah, I've done it too.
How? What has to happen? Well, I thought I wanted to stay. You hurt me. I'm not out of love with you.
So you're saying the scenario?
But you hurt me. I'm saying, what do I have to do?
So let me just understand.
For you not to do it again.
Hold on. Let me just understand what you're saying. You're saying we're together. I go out and cheat.
Yes.
Okay? You forgive me or semi-forgive me.
Yes. But maybe I'm still mad. Is that part of the problem? That's part of the problem. What if she honestly forgives you? What if it's an issue? She forgives you. Is it still negatively negotiated? I don't understand. Are you saying because you stayed?
Okay, because now I know that if I cheat, I say sorry and it's forgiven.
Yeah, so especially after the second time.
So you have to leave the person. All
you're saying. Oh, have a set aside.
You have no right to say anything at this point. Nothing.
Okay.
You're the fool.
You guys are blowing everything out of the water right now. You got to understand.
Yeah, no, fool me once, shame on me.
No. We didn't know.
I've known a guy.
Yes.
He was a habitual cheater. Okay. Yeah. And the girl kept on taking him back. But she would always complain.
Yeah, of course, she's hurt. She's mad. Like, she's resentful. These are all human things. Watch this.
Now, we're a group of friends. It's a crew of us.
Oh,
and she's
my
part
God,
of that crew, too.
Yeah.
Okay? So, it'd be like, you're abusing yourself at this point because you can't complain to us no more.
Oh, of course not.
You keep on taking them back. So, now, the precedent's already
and
set.
You know what? I like, okay. I, honestly, so, this might be unfair, but I think some of the women who I might have cheated on, really they want you to cheat because they like to play the victim card.
I don't think so, buddy. I don't know.
That's why I said that they
want. Maybe. Maybe.
Now they want to be the
chief. I won't say that doesn't happen. Oh my God.
No. But I believe that if one person cheats, the other person's already cheated. Maybe not physically or sexually, but
emotional.
Like.
Because what you're saying
a connection is two ways, it's real. Attachment, then you're looking at the person as an object. Yeah,
also,
then they could change.
Watch this. I'm going to say something that they're going to consider misogynistic.
Okay.
Okay? But we know this is real. Okay?
Men
don't cheat. Yeah, all women cheat. But men don't cheat based off of emotions, based off of a physical thing. Okay? Because at the end of the day, we can detach having sex from our heart.
You know what? I can't. I actually can't.
Some don't, but there are some.
Really?
Yeah.
You have to have some feeling for the person.
Yeah, but I'll tell you a funniest story.
Okay, wait. Let him finish his story.
All right, but it is true. There are some men, because if they sleep with a girl, they fall for her.
Yeah.
I crack a joke saying your dick is in your heart. Like, your heart's in your dick.
But
right?
There is a theory.
So when a woman sleeps with a man, okay, she's actually giving him something. Because she has to give up her body for you to, right? So there's more of an emotional
attachment. You're entering
attachment,
into her.
Right, yeah. Because of a physical attribute of it. And you could argue and say, women could cheat for pleasure.
I'm a woman, you're a man.
Women could
we don't
cheat,
know each other's experience.
Women could cheat for pleasure and blah, 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 and all this kind of stuff, right?
Yes.
But if she sleeps with that guy multiple times, sooner or later she's going to catch feelings.
Oh, yeah. I mean,
because I'll even use the most extreme circumstance. I know a girl who does porn for a living.
Yes.
Okay.
We were just talking about this. I'll bring
who
it back to Adam.
Porn
22.
For a living.
I've read a couple porn stars.
She gets paid to have sex with men. Okay. She could go and have sex with a guy on camera, get paid a lot of money, right?
Good job.
Thank you.
But she finds a guy in the street.
And
she falls madly in with her, that with that guy. Okay? She's even fallen madly in love with one of her quote-unquote co-workers.
Okay, stop right now. Right. I've got so much to talk about.
Well, I'll put a pin in that.
Sorry, let's put a pin in that. Adam 22.
Oh.
Adam 22. This is what we were discussing today. Adam 22.
He's a podcaster. He has a very popular podcast that's hip-hop-based.
Yes.
I've been following him for a long, long, long time before he even became super like popular.
But what else does he do?
Not really the Joe Rogan.
He's not like those big guys.
But he
like
also...
He's not like the Russian guy, Vlad, or something.
No. But he... I've been actually watching like podcasts before podcasts became like popular. So a lot of these guys I've been following for many, many, many years, and now they're blowing up. Okay? Yeah.
Do you watch his Plug Talk?
No, actually, I've never...
Okay, so he does a show. So he does hip-hop. So he's in two worlds, which is interesting.
Yeah,
I was
so
actually impressed that he
now,
was able to...
Now, watch this. Now, his girl... Sorry for cutting you off. His girl, Lena the Plug, I followed her way before she was even with Adam 22.
Okay.
So I knew about her way before.
Okay.
Right? And so he has this hip-hop... He has this hip-hop podcast where it's young-oriented artists. And I know because he's with Lena the Plug, they have their side business, which is basically a porn company.
Do you watch it?
No, I've never seen it.
You've never seen it?
No, because I don't do OnlyFans. I don't pay for OnlyFans. I don't go on OnlyFans.
No, they have it on like Pornhub and stuff. You can watch it on there.
I don't know.
Okay, so you heard what happened.
Yeah. So
she slept with her first, so... They do a side podcast together.
Mm-hmm.
So he does hip-hop on one side, but they do a side podcast. Hey, aren't you joining the conversation? Where are you going?
On relationships?
No.
Oh.
Where they interview people and then they both have sex with them.
What?
They have threesomes. I know. It's like a pretty fucking unique concept. It's like...
Well, yeah.
It's crazy because, you know, like it doesn't happen. They just got married. So she recently decided to sleep with a man. And so the internet's going crazy because in all those years, she never actually slept with a guy. So now she's sleeping with this black man and everybody's calling Adam 22 a cuck.
Well, that's sort of true, isn't it? But so what? Like, why is their fantasy anyone's business other than the three of them? Right?
Mature.
Like, I had...
Very mature.
I had a woman because of TikTok sort of, like, come on to me, and she wanted me to let her husband watch, and she was really into, like, putting him down on the internet and stuff. I thought that's just... It just didn't... suit me?
Yeah.
Like, it wasn't that, oh, it's so wrong, it's this...
Yeah,
it's
just wasn't
like,
your thing. Yeah.
Not my cup of tea.
I love that response.
Yeah.
I wish Ruben Kev would come back since he knew so fucking much about it. So, Stu brought up a controversial point. Stu says, if he cheats and his woman takes him back, let's say he cheats, she gets upset about it, maybe she doesn't have sex with him for 4 weeks. But once she does, they've renegotiated the terms of the relationship. And now he understands that the only consequence he gets for cheating...
That's some lawyer talk.
Is...
You bring that in a relationship? Yeah, I'm renegotiating the relationship.
I'm so relieved that you're there.
Come on.
He's saying that it sets the precedence for what the relationship is moving forward.
That's lawyer talk. That's not actually what's going to happen.
Of course it's going to happen.
No, it's not, Stu. Relax, bro. No one's renegotiating relationships like that, bro.
That's lawyer talk. No. You're not sitting down and doing it.
No, yeah, he just means that the precedence has changed. That you understand what the consequence of your actions
is. No.
You've changed.
I'm in a relationship and I've been in one for 20 odd years.
Yes.
No, don't work like that.
If a man cheats and you forgive him,
yes.
Have you now renegotiated the relationship for him to understand it's okay for him to cheat and this is the recourse of it? So this is the consequence. So whether it's big or small, whether it's I don't sleep with you for 2 weeks, whether it's, you know, we don't, whatever the consequence is. Maybe I say I forgive you, but I hold a grudge.
Right. So I think you have to, like, back it up way before and go, what motivated him to cheat in the first place? And that needs to be discussed. Because there's so many, because that will determine how you then, the consequence of it and how you proceed forward.
Do you sit down and ask that? How do you know why he cheated? Is that a conversation that you have?
Absolutely. If
you
go forward together as a couple.
Yeah.
Everything happens through conversation. If you can't not converse, you'll never get to the reason why he cheated in the first place. It's once you figure out, it's just like if I'm hitting my head, am I hitting my head because I'm frustrated, or am I hitting my head because I've got a headache? Well, you have to find out first before you actually apply the remedy. Do I need a hug because I'm frustrated? Or do I need an Advil because my head hurts? It's the same thing with cheating. You have to sit down and discuss and figure out what's the root cause for the cheat. And is it something that you both can work on? Or is it something that you can't? And that gives you an answer on how to move forward.
I love that.
That's what it is. If you get past it, the cheater knows that should I cheat again, if I feel like this again, or if I feel a different way I want to cheat, that these are the consequences. We go through a discussion, I go through emotions, and we work it out, and then it's forgiven, and we go on to the next time I cheat.
Okay, so then I'll challenge you and say, then what should comes out of it was something what we call a contingency plan. So if you say...
Are you a therapist?
No, sort of, not really.
Evolved, but, no, evolved.
But as a contingency is that, okay, so then if you cheat, so it's kind of like, you don't wake up one morning and decide, like, I'm going to blow up my high school, right? You don't decide one morning, I'm going to go cheat.
Thought of blowing up my high school.
Okay.
Exactly. There is a whole series of events that gets there before somebody does that.
Yeah, you put yourself in a position where you should.
So what we have to do is that you have to say, okay, if either one of us feels that they're going down that road again, that person needs to communicate to the other person so that they can veer off that road. But again, that has to happen through conversation. We
and
all know that.
And you have to not feel like going on that road again. Because if you went on the road and it was fun and there was only minor consequences, you might want to ride down that path again. Like I'm saying it in the situation.
Well, it's, yeah, but that's very cut and dry.
That's how human the brain works. Just, like, isn't neural programming how it works? Like there's pathways that are formed.
But we all, yes, but we're also in charge of our own bodies and our own actions. So to a certain extent, you have to be able to say, yes, I'm willing to detect that if I'm having these feelings again, I'm going to bring this to you, and we're going to talk about it. We're going to come up with our plan.
That can happen. Not all relationships are the same. He got me very down about it. I was feeling so bleak. I'm glad that you've added some hope and that I'm actually able to insert your side and your opinion of it as well.
May I add one last thing?
Yes.
The tricky part is that just because, you know, we all sing, correct? Some of us just naturally sing better. We all move our bodies, but some of us are just natural athletes. We all talk, but we're not all at ease at having conversations.
Yeah.
And that's the problem, is that a lot of times these things reoccur again because two people don't end up having healthy conversations.
And you know what? I'm sure in Stu's relationship, he is two conversations away from not cheating. I know that. I know that. I know that.
I
know that.
I
know that. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Human beings are different from flipping animals. Human beings are messed up.
No, they're not different. Yeah, they are different, but not that. Yeah, obviously they're different. But
no, I know.
You can trust
an
animal more than you could trust in a human being.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Well, I think there's a saying, man's best friend, and it's a dog. You know what I'm saying? And it's a man's best friend because your dog is not going to turn on you, your real dog. But your dog, your boy, your girl, your homie, your friend, they might and may turn on you, you know? Human beings have different tendencies, you know? Different people live, different species and living beings, they live different ways, you know?
This is what I'm saying.
Yeah,
so in Islam, they say that the animals actually just obey God.
Yes.
They don't have free will the same way we do. So they're like little angels. They just obey God.
Elephants bury their own. Elephants bury their own and remember where they buried them.
Yeah.
And go back to them.
Yeah.
They keep going back and seeing them. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
All these animals, they move different. Humans are just another species. They're like an animal almost, right?
Yeah.
But it's a different, you know what I'm saying? Like we came originally from, a man originally came from like an ape and a gorilla.
No. I don't believe that at all.
No, you don't think so?
No way.
So when the man, no, I'm not saying like became, we didn't, like a gorilla, we didn't become like from gorillas, but like our whole thing, we're like, there was gorillas around and apes, and then there was humans around. Like in terms of moving, walking, like we walk the same, you know what I'm saying? So it's like that shit, yeah?
Yeah.
But anyway, like I was saying, you can't, that's all bullshit. We don't know if that's true or not, whatever, that's small talk. But human beings, compared to animals, there's certain animals to be specific.
Yeah,
you're better off trusting in them because these human beings will turn on you. They'll turn on you for anything. They'll turn on you for money.
That's what I'm saying.
They'll turn on you.
We've got the duality. We've got the good and the bad.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So human beings, you gotta just stay clear from it, you know? Deal with the fuel, and that's it. Human beings are the reason why the world is how the world.
Oh,
well,
for
I think
sure.
There's so much
this
stuff
is
happening.
It. I did the math.
You think it's the animals
doing
that, all
no.
that stuff?
Everything
it's
bad is a human.
Who?
Adam22.
Yeah.
Final word on the...
I don't. There's no
I wasn't going to ask you. Oh,
Is there a final word? There is no final word for Adam 22. The saga continues, I guess.
Cool.
Seriously, because what can you say? He's gonna start a whole new trend, I think.
You think so?
I think this
having your woman sleep with other men for money.
I think women are gonna start being okay with this.
Hmm.
We're moving into a different direction in the world, so yeah, it wouldn't surprise me. You know what I'm saying?
Is it a trend?
You could start.
It's normal.
True. I don't know.
Okay.
That's what I'm saying. So, I don't have that experience, so I can't speak on it. But I feel like it could start a trend. You know what I mean? Just like how what's it called? Remember they were doing Ashley Madison.
Yeah. Encouraging cheating and stuff like cheating. That. Yeah. Yeah.
Apparently, there's a lot of people on the site.
Yeah.
And a lot of people like. Well-known people that were on this thing. So, again, like I said, this might have been already going on with the rich.
Now it's becoming modern.
Now it's leaking into the mainstream, and now, it's probably going to become more trendy now.
Scary thought, but I kind of think you might be right.
So the whole taboo of it is becoming
there is no wrong anymore. Remember, there is no wrong anymore. Huh. Really, what's wrong?
Huh. You're right. You're right.
Everything is moving into that direction where, this is... This is okay. And look, we're doing it on fucking, and we're making money off of it. Laugh if you want to.
It's not old.
Thank you for watching another episode of Shop Talk. Please remember to press that subscribe button down at the bottom. Peace.
I did it.